A major bridge is closing and a major intersection is reopening. Know before you go, Fox News' Paul Shankman is live in Maryland Heights now with more on a busy day for road crews and a confusing day for some drivers. Paul?
Yeah, Mandy, it is weekday number one and rush hour number two for MoDOT's new diverging diamond interchange here at 270 and Dorset. And as you can see, it seems to be working very well, though some drivers may be confused. At least the thing is finally back open. However, for those who use the Eads Bridge, they're going to have to deal with a closure starting tonight at 7.
What do you think it's going to do to traffic?
Well, it's going to make it a total mess.
And with that pessimistic assessment out of the way, here's what's going to be causing some drivers to go out of their way. The Eads Bridge will be closed for the next 40 days so the city can fix 5 failing expansion joints. Despite the fact the Eads underwent a $35 million renovation just 7 years ago, its unique structure presents problems.
Because it is so much steel compared to most bridges that are out there, it expands exceptionally a lot.
I commute it every day back and forth to work, but then we walk it for exercise and lunch.
Well, you can still walk it, but you're not going to be able to drive it. What are you going to do?
The train. As far as I know, the train's still running, right?
It is. As for businesses near the Eads, the Casino Queen is betting the closure will not be a problem.
Most of our customers either use the Poplar Street Bridge or the MLK. Those are just as easy options as the Eads Bridge is to get to the Casino Queen.
Meanwhile, back at the diverging diamond, which causes drivers to enter and exit 270 on the left side of opposing traffic, MoDOT has been watching the Monday rush, and since this is St. Louis's first diverging diamond, it expects some initial confusion.
Drivers are very adaptive in the St. Louis metro area. They catch on very quick, and I think already you've seen today that for the most part, majority, the motorists have caught on really well.
Here's a live look again at the Dorset 270 interchange. It is moving along swimmingly tonight, and we are entering the peak part of rush hour. It will close again at 8 o'clock on Friday until early Monday morning, probably 5 in the morning or so before the morning rush, because they still have some asphalt to smooth out there, and they still have some stripes to paint. And once they paint those stripes, it should be even easier for people to make their way through there. So what do drivers think of this? Well, there are diverging opinions about the diverging diamond, and we'll hear some of those coming up in our next half hour. For now, reporting live in Maryland Heights, Paul Shankman, Fox 2 News.
And for more on what you need to know about road closures before you go, cruise on over to fox2now.com and click on the traffic.